Hi guys, this is day one, and I'm about 30 kilometers out of Ladysmith, and I'm on my way to Cape Town, to Bellville, to get something first I need for my photography. And so basically this video is about my Nikon photo tour with my little quad. So I've made a short stop for a smoke break, as I don't really want to have a ciggy in the car, because obviously I'm going to sleep in the car, and one don't want to have it all smell all stale and terrible after a day or so. So it's going to take a little bit of discipline, frequent stops, not in a hurry. So yeah, let's carry on to Bellville. Part of this tour, and some of the stuff, is to capture dams. And just look at this drought. These dams are, all these farm dams are empty. And I wonder, once I start getting the major dams and waterways on the west coast, what it looks like. But this drought is really, as the impact is visible. I'll try and shoot from the car a couple of as I spot them. Morning. This was my stealth camp spot at the security shack here at the spar shop, and yeah, still a little bit dark, and but I had a nice rest last night. There was a few people that walked up and down here, but other than that, it was very nice, and very nice stealth camp place. There was an ATM around the corner, and the guy sort of throughout the night, not many, like only at the most five or six, but they came around real noisy, and I had a real good tight sleep, I would say, from midnight till about six. And the security guy had shifted, changed shift, so I tipped the one 20 bucks, and he was really looking well after me. So just I need to get some remnants of last night's dinner. Was a can of sausages, and okay, There's a few things. I was looking for the tin opener last night and didn't find the tin opener, so I'm here at the shop and I need to just buy myself a tin opener again. How stupid, I left the one at home. So there we have it. Okay, it's about on 7 now. I just parked around the corner. There's a security shack. Around that corner was where I parked last night. And this morning there's a bit of activities as the guys is busy to set up their stalls and things. And this is my last shop before going into the Cedarburg, so I will do a bit of shopping of little things I forgot at home that I need to get here. Idiot of me was the tin opener. Luckily I wanted to open a tin of, some of the tins had pull lids, and so okay, I discovered I need that, and then I need to get me a 5 liters bottled water. You obviously don't, when you travel like this fairly packed, you're not going to bother about taking extra weight on the car. So 5 liters of bottled water should do the trick. A tin opener, and that's basically what I would need. More and more and more. So and then down there is intersection where I will be turning left, and I've got 50 odd kilometers into Cedarburg, and I got my shot. I'm real happy that I got my shot of Gaido Pass. Last night I took out the laptop quickly and I had a look at it, and I'm real happy with that. And a couple of the photos in Beinskloof also look very good, and I'm very happy with that. And hopefully today we can get some Cedarburg shots, and tonight the idea would be to get some nice dark shots with some stars, hopefully. So far everything goes great. Okay, photos. This section of road is terrible. Basically, where I stopped at Oasis, I could have maintained an average of 40. This part of the road is bad. From Oasis down towards N7 is really terrible. And it's not getting any better, it's just getting worse and worse. And I set the GPS, I'm actually in second gear doing like 15 from Oasis all the way, and the condition of the road hasn't improved at all. So but I think I managed some great shots. Now I'm just looking forward to getting to the N7 on top. If the dirt road was anything like I had this morning with a start, I would have been happy, but this is terrible, terrible. And now I'm also driving towards the sunset. I got the sun constantly from the front, so yeah, this road is bad. And the guys are speeding on this road, eh? It's hard to believe how these guys drive. So yeah, I just thought I'll do that, but this is bad. N7 is the route that runs from Cape Town to Namibia. So I'm real excited to finally get off the road. There's a map of the Cedarburg. Okay, that's only the conservancy. Okay, anyway, so there we have it. Right on the N7 now. Okay, I'll do another stop now. Okay, this is where the buses come, and I'm going to park over there where that BM is parked. Now here is a spur sort of contraption. Hello. And I just want to see if they've got Wi-Fi here. Then I can maybe I just quickly post a few things, do my emails, etc. So I'm going to be quite happy. Okay, so this would be my stealth stop for tonight. Right, you guys, I'm here at the truck stop. I'm just set up in stealth mode. Over here is the trucker showers and bathrooms and toilets and things. They are just down here. This aisle over here, and just around the corner is where all the truck goes. Obviously that's where I am. Here is the garage. I've just put in this there's security cameras and stuff all over, and I have just put up the one shade. There's an orange light, you see that orange light falling on my car, and I put up that one shade on this side. I can see through, so I'm very nicely tucked in. And the buses, when the buses on the route come in, they would turn in here, and this is the area where the buses would stop. So I'm actually right on the this is the point where the buses offload the people. So I'm rigged for this stealth camp on the N7 Namibia Cape Town bus route, and this is my spot. There's a little bit of timing involved with this. I'll tell you about that now. Okay, I don't think you will see me in this video now. It's fairly dark, but the timing is for this stealth is very, very, very important, because the moment the bus comes, after the bus leaves, I must chuck off. So basically, I have a view. The car on that side is completely blocked off, a little bit visible behind me, and of the dark windows, while looking out of the front window. Tonight I'll sleep this way around. I got this view and this view, but nobody can see into the car. So I think this should give you guys a very good idea. Okay, this is a part of the video I want to do now. The buses is starting to come in, so what you gotta do is to do sort of a runaround for a bully story, because I'm sort of waiting for the Windhoek bus. So on the stealth, I'm waiting for the Windhoek bus, which comes at 6 o'clock, past 6 in the morning. Depends on how they do a border crossing. And so okay, this is sort of a bus from that direction, and since the people is informed that I'm waiting for the bus, these guys is running around for the bus, you know. So that side, there. So this is a private hire bus, but it's from the okay. So let's go back in. Now, this is the type of thing that you want when you stealth. This is the sort of thing when you stealth, because these guys are under the impression that I'm waiting for the bus. So now you gotta give them this, because the security and the pump attendants is all aware of the fact that you are actually waiting for the bus. So this works out fine for my video segment. And incidentally, this worked very, very, very well for tonight when I did stealth camping in South Africa. You gotta figure out the reason. Okay, there's a bus turning around now, And the bus is actually chucking off now. Now that is, this bus is from the same company that does the Windhoek, the intercity. Now this specific one was in fact a private hire, but it doesn't matter. The fact of the matter is it worked for the stealth cam setup. Okay, here comes our bus. Waved at the driver and he wooted back. Okay, there we have it. So you've got to have that stealth cam thing going. And I think. Okay. This is what things looks like in the morning. I have today. I have taken out the inverter. This is drive and charge day today. As you can see, everything neatly packed up again, and last night was actually a very, 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 very nice stealth. It was only this little speaker here of the radio, but you know, you sort of get used to that after a while. Okay, right. So what I'm going to do now is to make ready for breakfast. So breakfast, I'm going to make me some coffee now. So there's a security by that garage and they've got a kettle. So what I do is I just take my mug and put in my coffee stuff, go there and ask for hot water and Bob's your uncle, right? And then I'm going to have with a coffee, I'm going to have rusks, and that should just be very nice. So very happy. And then today, okay, let me just sort out this and then I'll get to what the plans are today. But thus far I'm happy, everything is working out perfectly to plan. Right, okay, chat you later. Okay, now I'm heading off towards Veldrift. Just chuck on the GPS. Now today is charge day. You see this inverter is running and my laptop is now charging. So the first thing I do, I first charge the laptop, and then this camera needs to be charged as well. This one charged quite quick. So I should have gone into town, but there's another turn off on here. Let me just check the GPS. Okay, that's fine. Right, I've got a, this is the village of Paketberg. Now I've stayed in at this garage a few times in the past, not long, and now I was supposed to come from that side where those machines are over that bulge, and then the detour came around this way, so I'm on the way to Velder. Terrible in the morning sun. Okay, another 18 or so kilometers to Veldrif, and finally on a nice piece of road after the piles of roadworks. And I just want to show you here in the car, the laptop is still charging. I just opened the laptop because I wanted to watch that little thing and just do a small little test. I might want to save time for the video conversions. This camera does record in massive files, and I convert them for the video, so that I can do while I'm driving as well. and then basically just sit and add the video together, and the next day driving just write the video. So constantly monitoring cameras and batteries and thing, all the batteries is charged, so it's brilliant. Off to the bird sanctuary, very very excited. Apparently there's not a lot of water in the river, in the estuary. The lady that was by the roadworks said that there isn't a lot of water, but I'm going to change the lenses, the camera lenses, and have the 18 to 200 on, and hopefully gonna get some great shots at the sanctuary. Okay, I've stopped now. I'm just before Veldrift, and this is sort of important. I'm going to prepare the car now so that everything is hidden, because I obviously want to go to the bird sanctuary to take pictures and so on. So I want to prepare the car in such a way that people don't see things. They mustn't see laptops and funny things. So basically, and I'm going to, and or me stopping there, switching lenses, etc. So what I'm going to do now is to put my stuff, hide them sort of out of view, and also switch camera lenses, etc. So that I do, that people don't stare at me while doing that. Okay, this is let's do this, and then off to the bird sanctuary. Okay, here I am at the bird sanctuary. Now there's a walkway here. I'm not going to bother to go with a video camera on the walkway, so I'll just take the camera in. But it's awesome, eh? It's a beautiful setting. So let's go take pictures. Now I can do a monopod video for a change. I am booked into, I'm now in the village of St. Helena Bay, and I wanted to put St. Helena Bay as a stopover and overnight, but not on stealth tonight. So I've got proper ablution facility into a legal campsite, and this campsite works out $100 now. Okay, per person, but now you need to evaluate what you get. It is now just after 12, So I've got the whole day here, and I got the evening here, and tomorrow morning I leave. This park is right on the coast, and I can see from here where I see plenty of birds, and I'm right on the ocean. And this is sort of the thing that you alternate with stealth camping. Okay, sometimes one gets to very interesting places, and today I'm on my way sort of inland away from the coast, and I came around this place. I saw this stall on the side of the road and found something very interesting. The tallest chair and the smallest chair. So from the road I saw this chair, and then I decided to stop here, buy a cool drink and so on, and start talk to the people. There's no signpost about this, and I managed to get a photo of the tallest chair in Africa and the smallest. The smallest chair is on a matchstick. And there's a neat little box, and on the matchstick is three little chairs under a magnifying glass, and I took a picture of that. So no sign about the tallest and the smallest chair, but in Africa, but this is where to find it. Very interesting, and just look at the photo of this. This morning, I didn't do much of a video when I left St. Helena Bay to basically to Cape Town side, or towards Cape Town, let me put it this way. I didn't do much video because it really wasn't necessary. So I'm booked now into the yacht club, which is 55 rand a night. So you don't need to stealth camp when you've got such an option, because I'm right here by the ablution blocks and in the campsite and everything, and at that rate you know, you don't need to stealth camp. So this sort of yesterday I was actually in, or not yesterday, in St. Helena Bay, I was a little bit upset about the guy at that campsite, because he had charged me over and above the begging. This guy had charged me $100. Now, yeah, occasionally you've got to swap from a stealth camp and having not proper bathroom facilities to some sort of a campsite. Say, I would say you can do stealth camp. You've got to divide this in. You can't constantly permanently stealth. That doesn't work out. So, but this guy was over and above the fact that he had charged me $100 and not giving me a receipt. I wasn't very happy with that. And then I figured out from other campers around there that something smelled fishy. And that's why that park was empty. So I wasn't too happy with that. I got on the run. I did a little bit of searching, you know, homework, and because I have seen a lot of the southern part of the west coast. I did see previously, and I was looking around for something interesting, and I found the tallest and the smallest chair, and I managed to take pictures of that, so I'm real happy. Let me just show you the surroundings here. Okay, as you can see, set up here close, that brown building over there is the ablution blocks. I'm just having coffee this morning, and over there is the Kloof Dam, and it's the where this tree line is supposed to be the water's edge. So this dam is empty. There's not a lot of water here, but I'll take some some photos of this. So I met some of the campers down here, talked a bit with them, and okay, so basically, yeah, this is it. So now hopefully get some little bit of rain. You can do with a bit of rain, and yeah, I don't mind. When I was here with my motorcycle previously in the tent, it's real messy when it rains, but now with this setup, I don't mind the rain. Okay, there we have it.